Hello there.
Don't mind me. Say, I thought I'd do another painting. I haven't done, well, in the past week I didn't do a lot, but then the past couple days I've been doing quite a bit. I got more supplies, so it kind of makes it a bit easier. Today I thought that I'd kind of do a sunset because they're kind of easy to do and they like look really nice. Now, this was really came really oily. I got new liquid white and it came so oily on the top, so I had to mix it, but I'm not sure how well it actually got mixed. I actually missed it, sorry. Just beat the devil out of it. So, for sunset or sunrise one, I usually just start with some yellow. Then I like to add like a touch of crimson or red to that to kind of turn it into an orangey glow. Kind of just make it stronger from the sides where the light's not coming from. And then some of this will just be in the water that I'll have wherever. Add a touch of blue to that water. So, why did I start painting? And why have I continued it? I think there's something nice about doing something creative where you're kind of expressing something that can't normally be expressed into words. And it's something personal, and it's kind of like a deeper part of you is coming out when you kind of do something like this. You know, it's kind of coming from a part of you that isn't thinking, that isn't the feeling kind of part of you. You know, and that's kind of like, I think it's nice to kind of learn to express that and just see it and see what it's kind of saying, because sometimes it can give us great insight into things. So now I think I'll do another mountain. I've just been trying to work on them a lot. I just mix a really dark colour so then it stands out, but this probably also means that it's a lot closer. Because the lighter something is, the more it is off to the background. Maybe I should do it lighter. A lighter one. Just see what color I kind of got. Try to make it like a grayish color. Because it's got that little red glow from like the sunset as well. See how that looks. I'm gonna do one more in the distance today. In the background. Yeah, this is really oily. Sorry about that, but it is what it is. Painting's such a nice experience because it's like you do what you want with the painting, you create what you want, you're doing the world that you want, and it's nice to kind of realize that you can kind of create whatever you want on this. You know, it's like a bit of power. Oh shit. Just having fun playing with the paint today. I'm just trying to get some of the yellow glow into this, so like the sun is setting on it. Yeah, that's good. Wipe that off on paper towel, and the sun's coming from there. Picked up a bit too much of that dirt. Usually I would have... Usually I would have dampened that down a bit more with the brush. Kind of like created some mist there. But it's just so oily and drab today. Yeah, there's so much oil and paint on that. That's a tip. If your liquid white is a bit oily or whatever, you probably need to brush it off a bit more than you normally would. See, that looks a bit better. And that's, I guess this is, that's a part of doing these sorts of paintings is, you kind of come against these things that kind of get in the way, and then you kind of can get annoyed about them, like in life, you know, all these little things that kind of happen, but we can just take them as learning experiences and kind of learn from it. And yeah, I think the main thing with mountains is just practicing like the edges, you know, when you first put it in. So darker in value, so it's a lot closer to us, you know, there's less light, there's more light towards the back. ever painted before or anything, you'll find that it's quite, it can be quite, almost therapeutic and really calming to do. Stuff that up a bit. I think the trick with this is trying to get it done in as little strokes and as little kind of thing as possible, because if you overdo it or you overthink it too much, then it kind of ruins the purpose of it, and you kind of muck around with it too much like this, and you kind of are stuck with something that's a lot harder to work with. I'm going to add some green. These are kind of this mountain colour that I have. Mix them a bit together. I think, say there's going to be kind of like a hill that's in here. Make it a bit darker and we'll do something in front of it. Probably not the best that I've done, but oh well, that's part of the kind of like the process of it. I'm thinking that there has to be a tree up here. I'm gonna do a That's a big one. Kind of fill out some grass a bit there. Then he needs a little friend. Oh, he didn't turn out so well. Maybe I'll turn that guy into a bush. We don't make mistakes, we make happy accidents here. I'm just gonna scratch a kind of trunk into there. There's another one there. Ooh. Then I'm gonna grab some of the paint, you know. Do it into this kind of color. Put a tree, I reckon. More yellow. Didn't turn out great, but now let's do the big tree there. Right, that was just kind of a quick sunset mountain kind of scene. Mostly just wanted to work on the mountains. I think the color underneath it kind of had too much oil on it. It was too oily. I'm just going to sign it. And that's done. All right. See you in the next video.